His grandfather, Berdimuhamedow, was a teacher who served in the Red Army during the Great Patriotic War as part of the 748th Rifle Regiment, of the 206th Rifle Division, of the 2nd Ukrainian Front. In September 1943, his unit was one of the first to cross the Dnieper River. He was later killed in an earthquake in Ashgabat in 1948. After taking office, Berdimuhamedow reversed Saper Murat Niyazov's more outrageous policies. Internet cafes offering free and uncensored web access opened in Ashgabat, compulsory education was extended from 9 to 10 years, and classes in sports and foreign languages were reintroduced into the curriculum. The government even announced plans to open several specialized schools for the arts. Government officials of non-Turkmen ethnic origin who had been sacked by former President Niyazov were allowed to return to work. He also restored the pensions of 100,000 elderly people whose pensions Niyazov had slashed in the face of an unspecified budget crisis. Later on, he reopened the Turkmen Academy of Sciences, which had been closed by Niyazov. In April 2004, then-President Saper Murat Niyazov suspended Berdimuhamedow's salary for 3 months because healthcare workers weren't being paid. The health ministry was also responsible for carrying out Niyazov's order to close all hospitals outside of the capital city and major towns in 2005. Gurbanguly Berdimuhamedow graduated from the Turkmen State Medical Institute in 1979 and started working in dentistry. He also received a PhD in medical sciences in Moscow. By 1992 he had become part of the dentistry faculty at the medical institute. In February 2017, he was re-elected to a third term as president of Turkmenistan, with nearly 98% of the votes in his favor and with an eligible voter turnout of 97%. Berdimuhamedow is a known lover of the color white, living in a white palace and traveling in white limousines.